For many years, NASA was the most prominent space firm in the world, particularly in terms of technological innovations. But not anymore, as SpaceX has changed the game for good. The Elon Musk-owned aerospace company has outperformed every other player in the industry, almost making a fool of NASA. Join us in today's video as we explain how SpaceX went from obscurity to becoming the most relevant space company in the world. Back in 2001, a rocketless Elon Musk set out on an ambitious journey to start up his space exploration company. At 30, he was already a successful entrepreneur with multiple thriving businesses, such as Zip2 and PayPal, among others. But there was a burning desire to extend his business empire into the world beyond. Mars, to be precise. So, the South African-born businessman sold PayPal to eBay for $1.5 billion, earning around $100 million as a result. Armed by this fund, Elon Musk travelled to France alongside his friend, Ardio Rezzi, and an aerospace expert, Jim Cantrell, hoping to buy rockets from European space company Ariane Space. Rezzi initially tried to talk Musk out of this crazy idea, but the entrepreneur's resolve was far greater than his friend's discouraging antics, so they flew down to France anyway. But on getting there, they realised the rockets were too expensive. But during the discussion, they overheard that some Russian officials were trying to sell refurbished intercontinental ballistic missiles, also known as ICBMs. So they headed to Russia, hoping to get a deal done. Several meetings were set up with different companies and stakeholders, including NPO Lavochkin, Cosmotrans, and officials from the Russian space program. As Rezzi would later recall, they had to bribe their way past some overzealous law enforcement officers at one time, only to get to the meeting and realised it was an unofficial vodka drinking contest. Then we started having meetings with the Russian space program, which is basically fueled by vodka, Rezzi said. We'd all go into this little room and every single person had his own bottle in front of him, Rezzi recounted. They'd toast every 2 minutes, which means 20 or 30 toasts an hour. To space! To America in space! I finally looked over at Elon and Jim, and they were passed out on the table. Then I passed out myself. Up next, the Russian officials decided to pay Musk and his entourage a visit in Los Angeles. But their demand would leave both Elon Musk and his friends surprised. We can't continue unless you give us $5,000 in cash, the Russian officials demanded. Getting that much funds wasn't exactly easy, especially since it was on a Saturday. But Musk and Tezzi found an alternative. They borrowed the money from a Mondrian hotel in West Hollywood and met the ridiculous last-minute demand. But still, it didn't change the countenance of the Russians towards them. They barely took Elon Musk and his friends serious, and according to accounts given by Cantrell many years later, one of the officials even spat on Musk. So he sought to meet with another set of Russian groups. This time he travelled to Russia with a briefcase full of dollars, hoping to buy 3 ICBMs. The initial agreement was to buy all 3 for $21 million. But once Elon Musk and his entourage got to the meeting, the Russians decided their new price was $21 million for each ICBM. And that was the last straw that broke the camel's back. Elon Musk had gotten tired of the endless negotiations, which seemed to be leading to nowhere anyway. Musk and his team decided to return to base in Los Angeles. And during the flight, Elon Musk turned to his friends and said, "Guys, I think we can build this rocket ourselves." And that was how SpaceX came to be. Officially founded on March 14, 2002, SpaceX started out without any significant investment. The $100 million would just be enough to fund 3 launches. Seeing that he couldn't afford top-notch engineers at the time, Musk named himself chief engineer, and they set out to begin their experiments. Between 2006 and 2008, SpaceX had 3 failed attempts at launching a rocket. Musk's $100 million initial investment was gone. I thought, okay, we can afford 3 launches. And then the 3rd one failed, Elon Musk said. It was a very, very painful exercise. We were just too stupid to know how to make a rocket go to orbit. But rather than close shop, Elon Musk invested more money, just about enough to facilitate 1 more launch attempt. If he failed this time, SpaceX would be folded and become history. Engineers tweaked a single line of code from the third attempt and tried the launch again. Fortunately, there were no complications this time. The Falcon 1 rocket successfully entered orbit, giving SpaceX a much-needed lifeline. The launch was generally cheaper than what was obtainable from competitors at the time. A few months later, SpaceX was awarded a $1.6 billion Commercial Resupply Services CRS contract by NASA. But Elon Musk was determined to reduce the price even further by building reusable rockets. Fast forward to 2015, SpaceX successfully landed a Falcon 9 rocket after many attempts. By 2017, the company had begun launching reusable rockets on land and at sea, something that had never been done before. Emphasizing this fact, SpaceX CEO Gwynne Shotwell said, "No one has ever done anything like this before. We're not one-way trip to Mars people. We want to make sure that whoever we take can come back." Meanwhile, Elon Musk had this to say during a SpaceX broadcast of the launch. "It's taken us a long time, a lot of difficult steps along the way, but I'm just incredibly proud of the spaceflight team. This is going to be ultimately a huge revolution in spaceflight," he added. A few years later, the company launched a side project called Starlink, a constellation of satellites in low Earth orbit that provides fast internet connection across the globe. Elon Musk had hoped that reusable rockets would help drive down the cost of launching rockets to space. And he was right. One Falcon 9 launch is rumored to cost around $62 million. That's a huge discount compared to the operating costs of NASA's Space Shuttle program. Back then, NASA spent $10.6 billion to develop the program. But at today's prices, a one-way trip to orbit aboard a space shuttle would have cost $49 billion. That explains why it was decommissioned in 2011. Going forward, the United States needed an alternative means of transporting astronauts to the International Space Station. But SpaceX wasn't in the business of sending humans to space just yet. So every time NASA needed to send astronauts to the ISS, it paid for seats aboard the Russian Soyuz rocket. Each seat cost about $81 million, or $97 million by today's calculations. But there was no other alternative. Meanwhile, NASA gave out contracts to SpaceX and Boeing through its Commercial Crew program to develop reusable, cost-effective, and innovative spacecrafts for sending astronauts to the International Space Station. SpaceX set out to build the Dragon capsule, while Boeing named its own spacecraft the Starliner. Despite Boeing's superior experience in the field and several months of delay, SpaceX completed its Crew Dragon project first. SpaceX was new to the game, and I think their advantage was their flexibility, their speed, and their culture that they could work in this fixed-price, more commercial-like environment. Christina Chaplin, a former director of the Government Accountability Office, said, "Many of the traditional aerospace companies doubted SpaceX's capacity to deliver on its promise of transporting American astronauts to space." A top executive from one of the competitors is known to have said, "SpaceX will never fly," claiming their rockets were held together by sealing wax and chewing gum. Others questioned the unprecedented methods that SpaceX deployed. But in reality, they were only scared of being unable to match the innovation introduced by SpaceX. Elon Musk's controversial personality didn't help either. As much as he was putting in the work behind the scenes, the tech billionaire was always up in the faces of his competitors, and he had a long-running spat with Jeff Bezos over a contract that SpaceX beat Blue Origin to. All that wouldn't matter though, because SpaceX continued to deliver when it mattered most. On May 30th, 2020, SpaceX became the first private aerospace company to fly NASA astronauts into orbit. It was an iconic feat because it also brought an end to the negative trend of American astronauts flying to the ISS aboard the Russian Soyuz rocket. The aerospace company even went the extra mile of designing a special, sleek spacesuit for the mission. You can see here how excited NASA astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley looked en route to orbit in their SpaceX high-tech spacesuit. "It was incredible," NASA astronaut Bob Behnken said of the launch. "Appreciate all the hard work and thanks for the great ride to space." Since then, SpaceX has become the darling of the space industry. NASA has since increased SpaceX's share of the contract by $900 million, taking the total value to $3.5 billion. The estimate for each mission is around $300 million. That would be enough to transport four astronauts to space for $75 million per head, meaning SpaceX is saving taxpayers around $22 million for every American astronaut that's sent to space. In addition, SpaceX beat Jeff Bezos' own Blue Origin to land the $2.9 billion contract for the Artemis mission that seeks to take astronauts to the moon by 2024. In the last 5 years, the United States Space Force has awarded 40% of its contracts to SpaceX. And in the next couple of years, Starship, a super heavy rocket designed by SpaceX, is expected to return humanity to the moon and power Musk's dreams of colonizing Mars. SpaceX has successfully revolutionized the space industry by doing the unthinkable. From designing cost-efficient reusable spacecrafts to landing rockets on artificial islands, the company has done virtually everything that was deemed impossible a few years ago. NASA seemed to have relinquished its place as the world's most innovative space entity to SpaceX, and we cannot complain about it as the rewards have been flourishing.